I don't know what that's about.
Hi, my name's Lorraine, Lorraine Pugh, and I'm coming to you from Cyprus. And this is my video series all about yarn, mainly, and crochet. I like to call myself a bit of a crochet designer, and I'm getting to grips with knitting, slowly. I keep picking up knitting projects and putting them back down again to then reach for the crochet, because I'm so much quicker with crochet, and, well, not quicker, but I just, it comes so naturally to me now, whereas knitting is a bit harder. Show notes for this episode, which I think is episode 9 now, and we're sort of nearing the end of November, but the show notes should be in the thingy below, in the box below, because this video is on YouTube and I'm not on anything else. That's why I feel a bit uncomfortable calling this a podcast, so I tend to just refer to it as video series, because I honestly don't actually know what a podcast is, so there's that. I've also got a blog, lorrainepughdesigns.blogspot.com, and that has got the show notes on there and then some other stuff like information about the yarns that I show, because I do really love hand-dyed yarns, indie-dyed yarns. They are my favourite. I fell in love with them. Actually, I initially fell in love with them at a trade show, but really at the beginning of this year, in about May, I think it was. So, blog. What else? Facebook page, Lorraine Pugh Designs. Facebook group, Lorraine Pugh Designs Project Bag. Neither of which have got much activity going on. The Lorraine Pugh Designs one has, the page. The group hasn't yet, because I don't think it's really kicked off yet. But there's also a Ravelry group. I just got cut off by my naughty phone. Apparently I didn't have enough storage. Us crafty people will know, can't stop taking pictures. So I just had to delete some and then get rid of those. If you're not on Ravelry, then you should be. And also Instagram, actually. I'm on Instagram as Lorraine Pugh Designs. And it's fantastic. It's brilliant. I think it's better than Pinterest. And since I started on Instagram, I just can't stop. It's great. So today, I'm totally disorganised. I'm not prepared at all, but I think that's sometimes better, a bit more natural and free-flowing. Today I'm drinking Cypress Mountain Tea. You can only get this in two places on the island. It's organic and natural, obviously. It's delicious. It's so good. I get it from my local garden centre. It's really good. I'm looking at it because it's actually really too hot to drink. I thought I might be able to get away with it, but it's really hot, so don't want to be doing that. Today I kind of really want to show you some of the things I've shown you in the past that I've not really carried on with. Well, I am carrying on with them, but put stuff down, pick stuff up. So I think one of the first things I'll show you, this is actually quite funny because I forgot to bring it over here. I think I was planning on putting it about here, but I forgot. Is my latest design that I finished. Hang on, let me show you my dog Maddie, because she's just come to say hello and she's so cute. Mads, come. Hello, say hello to all the lovely people. Look, what's that? Look, there you are. You're a good puppy, you are. My latest design. So this is going to be quite funny. I'm not even going to press the stop button, but I'll just go and get it. Hang on just a second. Oh, and forgive all the rubbish behind me. I'm wrapping Christmas presents up. This is going to crack me up, because I'm not going to be able to, because it's on a dress form. So it feels like I'm like carrying a dead body. Right, that's not even funny, is it? Right, let's just put this over here. Probably can't see it from there anyway, no. Right. I've got a great idea. Let's just fiddle with these knobs. Sorry. Oh dear. I'm in a really good mood today. I'm normally in a good mood. I suppose good mood's the wrong word. I'm in a non-nervous mood today. normally I feel that I have to, come on, you can do it, lefty loosey, righty tighty. Normally I'm in a slightly nervous mood, I don't know why. If you record videos of yourself, I do think there's like a teething period. Am I even undoing the right one? I don't know. There's a teething period, I think, of seeing yourself. And obviously sometimes, in the early days, I didn't edit the videos. Couldn't really be bothered. But the more it's gone on, and actually I bought some software, which is fantastic. It's Windows Movie Maker, and I highly recommend you buying that because it's not expensive. Can't remember how much it is, like 20 euros or something. And so I'm able to edit the videos now because some people are asking to see me in Cyprus, life in Cyprus and stuff. So downloaded that. And so now I do edit videos. I have to watch myself, and that's the bit that I just think, oh. And sometimes I've watched some bits and I just think, that's just not me at all. I'm not very laid back in them. I can be quite rigid, especially I think it wasn't helping sitting at the table like this. It's not happening. Ooh, thanks. Right, let's show you. This is it's sort of a scarfy shawl. It's called the Undefined. Say hello. It was inspired by a conversation I had with someone. I think it was in a bakery. I can't recall the complete conversation, but they were just basically surprised. I was wearing this Red Hot Chili Peppers t-shirt, my some comfy jeans, my Thundercats trainers. So I was looking quite boyish, I suppose. And we just got chatting, and they were quite surprised when they learned that I liked to crochet. And it just got me thinking about the sort of stigma that crochet has. And I think they're expecting me to wear some floral nightgown and be decades older. So I just wanted to do a sort of a design that was getting away from that. And I wanted one that would go quite well with some of my grungier clothes as well, so I chose the colours for that. But it's I'll show you it in close detail. It tapers off to an end, so you can tie it nicely if you want to as well, tie it in a knot. And it's basically a massive chevron shape, whether or not I'll be able to show you it in its entirety. But it's quite long, and so it is sort of a, there we go, chevron shape, comes to a point, obviously the same at the other end. And it's called the Undefined because if you were watching my last episode, I did read out a quote from Eckhart Tolle's book, A New Earth, and it was, I might even be able to say it off by heart, do not allow others to define, I'm not going to quote this because it could be wrong, but do not allow yourself to be defined, but do not quit defining yourself to yourself and to others. To define yourself, I don't know, I'm not going to try and quote it. I'm really bad at remembering dates and letters and numbers and stuff, so I'm not going to do that. But it basically said, if people want to put you in a box and it's limiting themselves, and it's their problem, so just do your thing and forget rules and boundaries and stuff. So that is it. So you can wear it a few different ways. I really like it like this, and as it was on the dress form, really wrapped around, because what I wanted was something that was actually going to be really practical, because when I'm wearing t-shirts and jeans, I'm normally in a practical mood. When I say practical, I mean doing things, you know, not doing things. Going to the park with my son, who's two, and he's nearly three. I'm going to climb with him and go on the monkey bars, or try to, without breaking them and stuff. So I wanted something that's going to be practical in the winter, like all snuggly and warm. Not something that's just going to be looking pretty and delicate. Which is kind of one of the next things I'm going to show you, actually, a more pretty and delicate version of things. But yeah, so it's just got this quite surprising lace trim that perhaps is a bit unexpected as well. I wanted to... Black lace, there's something that's sexy about black lace, isn't there? So I thought I wanted to put that on there as well. Because us crocheters can be sexy as well, can't we, if we want to? So yes, that is the Undefined. By the time I've uploaded this video as well, it should be all up on Ravelry. So that'll be good. Let's just put it like that, whatever. No. Oh, and you can wear it back to front as well. So if you're just wearing a vest, but there's a nip in the air, You can wear it the other way, so it would look quite cool. Whatever colour you do this lace in, a colour where that really would stand out up against, say I was wearing a white vest, that would look quite cool with this. It would look really, really nice on the back. Right, let's see if this is too hot still. Yeah, it's too hot. Right, next project, next design in progress. I'm actually doing it in this. This is what I'm carrying it around in, this tin, an old sewing thread tin from my mum's shop. Oh, and the little sticker from my little boy, stuck that on there and coloured it in. And I love it because I've got in here a magazine that my mum bought for me, and it's a really Christmassy edition. So I'm currently reading this, and I apologise if you don't celebrate Christmas, but I do. So it'd be silly for me not to share this, and it is the inspiration of where my next design came from. So it's in there. I'm using these gorgeous yarns, but not only that, my little notions pouch, which I keep my scissors in, is like a dark green leather thing. Cute little leaf on there as well. My dark red scissors. So just even that's kind of red and green and red and green. I was obviously inspired way before Christmas doing that one. So I'll show you the yarns before I show you the actual item. And the reason they're cut off is because I'm doing stripes and I'm able to show you now. This yarn is called Colour Theory, and it's hand-dyed by Kate. That's her company, hand-dyed by Kate. And this one is called Overripe Raspberry, and it's by Dyfer Wool. They're also known as Dyfer Yarn. And it's merino silk, this one. Gorgeous. Only the best. And this one is Yak. I think it's, can't remember if it's Yak and Merino, I reckon it is. Maybe some nylon in there as well. I'll actually probably be able to tell you, because I'm hoping that I've got the thing in here. I haven't, and I just spilt all the beads out in there. There we go. Because I'm also using some gold beads. I will show you the project in a second, with those gold beads, so absolutely lovely. I'm not too worried about not showing you the cards, because I've shown them in the one before, but also all the information will be in the show notes, so just have a look at those. So that's those. The actual item itself, I'm just going to put all of these back in here, because I've got to, the minute I press stop, I've got to walk to the nursery to collect my little boy. And I tell you what, both my cars are broken down, and I really don't care, because it means that I can walk everywhere. I've got all the shops within walking distance. Walking to collect my little boy and walking to take him in the mornings is lovely, so I'm loving it. You're right there, Maddie. My dog's coming to see me. So anyway, Maddie, do you want to come up and say hello again? Come here. Come up. Oh, hello. Hello. Can you say hello to there? Is that there you are? You cutie. Maddie. That's Maddie. That's you. She does this head tilt. I won't be able to show you now, but if I say to her, Guten Morgen, she tends to, tilt her head. Can you see that? Matt, come here. Come here. I want you to show you. Come here. Guten Morgen. Guten Morgen. I don't know why, it's just so cute. Anyway, so obviously this is not finished yet. The beads will run all the way along on the bottom. But look at this so far. I am loving this. It's not going to be massive. I wouldn't call it a shawl, really. I'd call it sort of a neckerchief type thing. And it will be more of a pretty dainty thing, definitely for Christmas time. I'm going to wear it around the house at Christmas time. And I'm going to the UK for Christmas, you see. And I just love how the beads just do that thing, and the stitches that I'm doing sort of create this twirling. Can you see that? I'm just absolutely in love with this, and I'm not just saying that because it's my design. I am going to make this in quite a number of colours, and because I love it so much, I'm going to do, right, let me just slow down a second, right, it's called Festive Jester, because I think it's festive. And the beads just sort of remind me of a jester, you know, like a jester's hat or his shoes. But I'm going to do a giveaway that will run all of December, and it'll be on Instagram. So if you're on Instagram, that'd be good. In fact, I'll do it on Facebook as well. The Facebook one will be slightly different, I think. We'll see. But on Instagram, it'll be a giveaway. There will be quite a few steps. You have to like the picture. You'll have to tag two friends in the comments because it's a promotion for this pattern. You'll also have to share the picture and tag me in it. And then you'll actually have to direct message me your email address, because everyone that does all those steps will receive the pattern. It won't be like I won't draw a winner. Everyone that shares it does all those steps, because there are quite a lot of steps, let's face it. Everyone that does that will get this pattern for free. It will be a paid for pattern otherwise. Not too expensive, but it will be paid for otherwise. So yeah, if you're on Instagram, then that'd be really cool if you could do that. And I'll do the same on Facebook, I think, but it will be the same. You will have to tag friends, share the picture, because I am doing it to try and put myself out there a little bit more. So obviously by sharing it, people will see it, and by tagging friends, those people will see it. And because of that, because it seems like a bit of a, I don't really like the idea of it, to try and force people to do it. So as they're doing me a favour, you guys are doing me a favour, it only seems fair to just let everyone be a winner and get the pattern. So yeah, Festive Jester. And the colours, I just love the colours. I just think they work so beautifully together. The first pattern I ever did, which is called Flight of the Fabled Romance, which was inspired by sort of a bird's outstretched wings and a heart, a central heart, that took a long time to design and to make, and it's a labour of love. It's about three skeins, three 100 gram skeins. I'd say that's probably one of my favourite, well, my favourite, but this is kind of high up there with it. Even though it's much smaller, it's much more simple. It's just, I think, because like the Flight of the Fabled Romance, the idea of doing another one of those is, although it's exciting, it's still also, wow, it's going to be a bit of a long-term project. Whereas this is one of those, I just want to make loads, and I could make loads, and I could just have this. And also, once you've done the first row, or when you understand what the row is, because there's only one row to the pattern, once you do that, you're just working back and forth doing that same row, so it's really easy to remember. And I've got my own little trick with how to add these beads on, and it's really, it was trial and error, but it's simple, and you get a great effect because you get to see the beads from both sides of the fabric, so that's really cool. So that's that one. Let's have some of this because my mouth is going dry. I wasn't looking when I was drinking that, and these buds of this mountain tea are actually still in there, and I just swallowed one, and you're not actually supposed to. I'm sure it won't harm me. Hopefully I'll be okay. So this is a work in progress that I showed you a while back, but I feel the need to update you all on it. Let me just show you the pattern first, or a picture of it at least. Let's just hope that I have a good picture of it. It'll be in here somewhere. It's basically a crochet corset, and it was for the end of October, that festive time for some of us. I was going to host a pumpkin party, so that's it. That's a corset. It didn't go ahead because of some work that needs doing here in my apartment, but also I took my little boy to another party, and which was great because they got to run around and they absolutely loved it. Whereas if I were to have the idea of the party that I want to do here is a little bit more calm down than what this mental one was, so I'm thinking the actual vibe, the idea of the party, it will be quite interactive as well for the children, and there's not really a lot of space here to run around, so I'm thinking maybe for a few years time do the sort of style party that I'm hoping to do. But I'm not saying this will take me a few years. I definitely want this for other dressy uppy occasions and stuff. It's definitely sort of a fancy dress cosplay style thing. And so here it is. I didn't host the pumpkin party, but I love this. It will need blocking when it's done, just because of it being in my bag. But the yarn I'm using is, I think, is perfect for this because it's given it kind of a bit of body, I suppose is the right word. It is a cotton by DMC and it's called Petra. And the colourway I'm using is kind of, what number is it? 5646. And it's sort of a gunmetal, sort of pewter colour. In actual fact, some people have said it's khaki. It's like that dress thing. So what do you guys think? Is that khaki or is that like grey? It's really in between there. And I find colours really surprise me. And in fact, today is one of those examples because when I was just getting ready this morning, I put on this khaki vest, this one here, one of my favourite colours, that's khaki. Complete with sweat marks, check that out, it just shows you how hot it still is here. This was on the top of my pile of jumpers that I've recently got out from storage, winter clothing storage. And I looked at it and I thought, it's a shame I haven't got that in another colour to go with this because these having short sleeves on the jumper are perfect. And this was actually from the charity shop at the end of my road. So it costs like £2 and it's knitted. And I thought, this is actually a great pattern, I think. One day when I do get better at knitting, I'll try and copy this pattern, I think. But when I grabbed it and I put it next to the vest thing just to see, I was really surprised to see, I think they actually go together really well. And so yeah, maybe one day I will put these colours together. What do you think? Like a rose and khaki. Do you think they go together? Somehow they kind of do. I don't know if you're seeing. It looks more terracotta, doesn't it, on the video? I can't really tell. But another reason I'm in a really good mood today is because I've been really poorly, really feeling the need to vomit and not being able to eat much. And normally when I get that kind of sickness, the next few days, once I've gotten over it, I get a lot of comments from people saying, you know, you look deathly ill, you look gaunt, because my metabolism's really fast, so no matter how much I eat, I can't seem to gain weight, so the weight doesn't really come on very quickly, so. And also my boy, who's brilliant when I'm ill, because he's happy to just snuggle up to me. He's amazing. We were having a laugh and he's been like scratching my face and stuff. So that's what that is. I'm not being hurt. But so that's why I'm in a really good mood. When you've overcome a sickness and suddenly you feel sort of all right again, even though I'm not 100% still all right, is just like that, wow, that amazing, oh, I'm so happy I'm not poorly feeling. I'm going to have to take this jumper off to show you this next thing, I think, because I really would like to put it on to show you. It was a really, really random project. What happened, Ali from Starry Eyes Ali on Instagram, she has a podcast, Little Drops of Wonderful, which is amazing. It is actually now like one of my favourites. One of my favourites. She loves crochet as well. She's just so lovely and down to earth. Anyway, I'm not going to get all gushy. But she was using a yarn by My Mama Knits, who also did these yarns here. This one's called Kelpie and this one is called Burke and Hare. My Mama Knits also does an amazing gradient called, let's just pull those bits, Squid on the Beach. And it's this one here. And I saw that Ali had made the hitchhiker shawl in it. And I just thought, I've just got to use that yarn. Even though I had it set aside for something else, I've got it in a DK weight. I just worked up a piece in it. And then I also had some knitting that I'd shown you in the past, which was, I was using a yarn called Rainbow in the Puddle by Monika from Comeragh Yarns. And that's that colourway. It's just amazing. And I was in such a, like, I don't care what anyone thinks mood that I thought I would make this crazy, crazy hoodie. And also I really wanted to wear this colour and wear this colour. And so I just wanted them on me. So this project will be a hoodie. And it's totally freestyle. I'm just sort of going with it, making it up as I go, counting bits, measuring it on me, putting it on this dress form, which is my size. And I'm just loving it. I haven't worked on it for a couple of weeks, obviously, because I've been ill and stuff, but every now and then I do a little bit. Not a lot has been done, but so this is quite entertaining, isn't it? Am I doing that the right way? Yeah, this is the right way. So this is it so far. Have a little bit of imagination. So that is to about there. Let me just make sure I've got, yeah, so it's about there like that. There will be side bits put in. And I also thought, you know, in a lot of the knitters talk about their Rhinebeck sweaters, don't they, in America? I thought maybe this would be my version of that. I'd love to go to Yarndale one day, but because it requires a flight as well, I'd have to coincide it with other things. But so that I will put a panel in there. But this is going to be a hood. But as I was making it, before I started this brown bit, in fact, even now, it looked like a really cute collar. And I've written out exactly what I've done so far. So maybe I'll make another one, but actually have a little collar on it. And it was Lisa from Lisa Pine Notes. She's also got like a crochet video series where she has tutorials and everything else. Lisa's really, really sweet. We have a good communication on Instagram and YouTube as well. I think it was Lisa that said that it would look cute with just a collar like that. Like, I'll have to make another one. So that's another work in progress that I've not shown you for a little while, but I just want to, I suppose, like an end of year recap, I suppose, of all the things to promise you that I'm not really bad and totally forget about things and hide them away. But I just, when it's when I get a design idea in my mind, because I would like to do these designs as my full-time job, that sort of does have to take priority. So that's that one. The other yarns I've used on there, by the way, are plain colours, and they are, I think they're James.C.Brett 100% Merino baby yarn. It's very soft. Again, all the information will be in the show notes. So the next thing I started, well, the next thing I'll show you that I've started is this authenticity shawl. This I intended to be a long-term project anyway, because this has been done in an Aran weight yarn, a worsted weight yarn. I started this as part of Jaclyn Salem from the Brooklyn Knitfolk did a element along KAL. And I started it knowing that I'd take ages with mine, because I'm doing it in a 4-ply weight. I'm using this gradient yarn by Wool Elf. Let's pull that out a bit. This is amazing. It's called Curry and Saffron. And I'm using these gorgeous stitch markers, toffee apple style stitch markers, from Crafty Cat Knitty Bits. That's my dog. She's a little bit territorial, best word. So yeah, this is a long-term project, but this is how I'm going so far with the lace. I've undone this so many times, but I don't really care. I've managed to make it look okay in areas where I've thought I'm not going to bother undoing that too much and just rehash it a bit. But I am really enjoying it, and in fact, I imagine if I were to pick this up tonight, I would want to just work on this. But I want to work on everything. So that's something that I'm doing, which is going to be a long-term thing. But again, just showing you to say, I'm not forgetting about all these things. And then the next thing I'll show you, I showed you last week, this gorgeous yarn by Dye for Yarn. These gorgeous colours. I think of honeybees. And the reason I think of honeybees, these colours, I'll just quickly say, no, Too Hard Butter Cookie, Sport Weight, Merino, I think it's 100% Merino, let me just double check. Yep, 100% Merino. Burnt Cinnamon Bun, Boiling Cacao, or Boiling Cacao Beans, sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. Dye for Yarn are an amazing yarn dyes if you want solid colours, like the red that I'm using for wherever it's gone. Where is it? It's on here, isn't it? The red I'm using for that. Whenever I know that I want a specific colour, they'll always have it. They're just amazing for that. Don't do variegated yarns so much. But those I bought because this gorgeous, gorgeous pattern, which I just really want to start, but I know that I shouldn't yet, and it's by Christina Haddering, who's also known as A Spoonful of Yarn. It's called the Hotel of Bees shawl, and I'll start that at some point. So that's that one. So I wanted to just recap those things. There's probably one or two other projects that maybe I've started that I don't know if I've shown you. If I have, I probably would have finished them. I really want to get my current projects done now. Just all of these, I want to slowly just start to finish those off now. I'm going to the UK for Christmas for a couple of weeks, so really I should think about what project I'm going to take for that, because it should be something that I've already started. But I really think that I'll probably end up just doing another one of the Festive Jesters, because I know what colours I want to do in that. In fact, they're colours that are inspired by this necklace, which I got over here in Cyprus by a company called Peace Elements. They're also on Etsy. It's polymer clay, and I think I can't remember what you called this. It's like a birdstone arrowhead with a tiger's eye there as well. And if you've watched previous episodes, I talk about the colours that seem to suit me, autumnal colours. And I've found since I've done that, and I've gone through all my wardrobe and kicked out all the other colours or dyed a lot of things, so they're all similar tones. Like this is what happens. Like today, this khaki top and this dark, like dusky deep rose colour, they all tone in together really well. So they're clothes that you wouldn't sort of expect are going together because they're all in that autumnal palette. And I am going to make another one of these in stripes of rainbow colours, and I'll post in a picture on Instagram later of the colours, because it will be the rainbow of colours that I have for autumnal yarn, which I'll show you actually, because I do carry it around with me in my purse. And I highly recommend you do it. I think it's called the 16 Colour Seasonal Analysis. You can sort of do it yourself, just looking at yourself, figuring out if you're warm toned or cool toned, and then colours of your eyes and your hair. It all affects how clothes do or don't suit you. It doesn't really matter at the end of the day. If you want to wear crazy colours like on my top I'm doing, I think you should just do that. But if you do want to not have to buy too many clothes, or when you are out shopping because you need something, to know what to look for. It's really easy for me now when I go in a shop. I know that, say I wanted a short sleeved hoodie, I'll go in the shop, look around. If I see there's five colours but none of which are suiting me, I just don't bother getting it. And so it's much quicker and easier and more enjoyable for me, because I'm not really one to just want to stand and browse for a while. I kind of want to get in, get the job done. I printed this off. This is from Pinterest. I think this is called Toned Autumn Palette. So all these colours suit me well. And if you look, you'll see that there's actually every colour of the rainbow in there. They're just the different tones. And it's like that, whatever colouring you are. If you look at the 16 type season analysis, just do a quiz. You'll find one online, and just start having a look through it. It is really interesting because you can wear any colour. Like there's a red for any colouring. There's a blue for any colouring, but it's just picking the right ones. And so the scarf I'm going to do, or neckerchief, would you call this? What would you call it? In this, I'm literally going to just do these colours. And I've got to admit that yarn, because I'm toned autumn, it means that all colours I wear look good on me if they're toned with grey, which all these have got a slight tone of grey, and perhaps not even that one has, it's just showing quite saturated on the screen. These are all in there. This is because this is yak yarn. Yak is grey, so the colours have been put onto this grey, so all these colours are in here are toned with grey like that, so that's why this really suits me, which is great. And when I talk and do things at the same time, when I go on autopilot, I nearly didn't put that back in my purse, which... So yeah, that's my tip of the day, even though I've shared it with you already in a previous episode. Poor Anne, a lovely friend of mine called Anne, who also comes into my mum's shop a lot. She comes to our craft groups. Hello Anne. She kindly gave me this amazing shawl, and it's blocking at the moment, and she knows it's blocking, and she's like, oh, I'm sure she's waiting to see it. She's not like mentioned it to me though. But it's blocking on this here, and I'm having to block it in stages, because only parts of it fit. So, because it's actually blocked out to be quite big, and I just can't wait to show it to you. But I'm really sorry, Anne, I can't show it today. But now that I've got all these projects out of the way, definitely next time, in 2 weeks, I'll have finished blocking. I've got about one corner left, about this much to do, so I'll do that. I can't show you that. But I have been wrapping up some bits and Christmassy stuff, and I've enjoyed it so much. One thing I've wrapped up for someone that I talked to online, which I've never really had an online friend before, or friends, which I have now. So next year I'm definitely going to make up some boxes for those of you who I've met online. Lily, the lovely Lily from Nordic Stitches podcast, she showed interest in this colour tone guide. She said, oh, where can I get one from? And I said, oh, don't worry, I've got a spare one, I'll post it to you. Went to get it, it wasn't where I thought it was, and I've been searching for it ever since, so I've given up looking for it now. Lily, I'm going to send this to you, so don't worry about that, you will get this one. So I thought I would just mention that. What else? I think that's wrapping it up really for this time around. I'm sure every time I press stop and when I come to uploading it, I always think of something else to say, but yeah. I think that will have to be it. The only other thing is my Crozy Memories blanket, which is not laid out anymore. It's rolled up, but I've still only... that's what I'm trying to show you. Can I show you here? This is another thing. I've only sewn up one way, so I'm yet to go back the other way, which is why I don't really want to hold it up, because it's actually the wrong side that I'm showing you. There we go. There's the right side. And on my blog, I've included a zipper join thing there, how to do that. A lot of this stuff I've mentioned in previous episodes, so I'm sorry if you've already watched all of those. I'm just sort of recapping everything today, and obviously wanted to show you these. I did want to let all the viewers know that this Festive Jester will be free for anyone that does all those steps, so... I wanted to get that out there. So yes, I think I'll be saying bye-bye for now, and take Maddie Moo, my doggy, we'll go and walk and go and collect my little boy. So yes, I hope everyone has a lovely 2 weeks until I see you next time. Happy knitting, happy crocheting, happy whatever it is that you do, keep in touch. I'm really enjoying keeping in touch with everyone on Instagram or Facebook. It's mostly Instagram. Ravelry too, a lot of people use that. I find it quite cumbersome messaging on Ravelry, I'm not sure why. It's the zooming in, me having to zoom in on my phone to type, and it's such a hard life, isn't it? but Instagram's very quick and easy, I find. The only thing I haven't learned how to do on Instagram is how to just look at my messages. I've found that the only way I've seemed to do it is by clicking on a person that I've had a message with before, and clicking to write a message to them and then it coming up. So if you can answer that question for me, then that would be great. Yeah, that's about it. Another thing that I would like to mention is, if you know of many crochet podcasts, then I'd love to hear about them, because you know, no matter how much you search, you're not always gonna, the results aren't gonna come up, and often it comes up with the most popular ones. And I'm not being funny, but sometimes the most popular ones, in my opinion, aren't always the most enjoyable ones. I like the ones that are all down to earth, you know, and not, you know, I think sometimes the things can become popular if it's like very all clean lines and everything, and I'm not about that, and I enjoy watching the ones where people aren't either, and it's all, you know, warts and all. Someone who I love, and I've mentioned before, is Amber from the Yarn Junkie podcast. I just think she's amazing. On Instagram, if she's having a bad day, or even if she's feeling quite tearful, she'll share that, and I think I think that's great. I think, not that she's sad, obviously, but to show that she's human, because it kind of, sometimes if you are having a bit of a bad day, And you're looking at pictures on Instagram and it's all pretty and beautiful and all staged, like I did. I staged a picture earlier, although I was actually reading the magazine and crocheting. I put it all out in a way that looked really, really nice. Amber doesn't do that. She's just, she does upload some lovely pictures, but she'll also show the days when she's sad, and it kind of makes you feel more connected, I suppose, because you're all still human and we all have those bad days. So yeah, do recommend to me some crochet podcasts. There are so many knitting ones out there which are lovely, but I would like to see more crochet ones, so if you know of any, let me know. So have a lovely 2 weeks and chat to you online if I don't see you in person, which some of you who are watching, I know I will see you in person soon. So take care and speak soon. Ta-ta for now.